Good morning. Now we discuss a special theory of relativity. In Newtonian mechanics is applicable only when the velocity of particle is much less compared to the velocity of light. So when the velocity approaches the velocity of light, we will be dealing with the special theory of relativity. So the state of a system, which state I am situated? Now I am in rest with respect to this board. When I take the reference as sun, with respect to sun, earth is moving. So I am situated in earth. So I will also be moving with the earth. So with respect to sun, I will be in a state of motion, and with respect to this white board, I will be in a state of rest. So as the reference changes, the state of system also changes. It can be in state of motion or it can be in state of rest. The reference object with respect to which the motion of an object is specified is called a frame of reference. Frame of reference. So frame of reference is an object with respect to which we can specify the motion of object. If the frame of reference is at rest or moving with a uniform speed. Consider one frame which is at rest. With respect to that, another frame of reference, this frame I am taking it as S, another frame S prime, which is moving with a uniform speed V. Uniform speed. Then these frame of references are called inertial frames. Inertial frames of reference. So they are either at rest or moving with the uniform speed relative to each other. Such frames are called inertial frames of reference. Now if a frame of reference is accelerating with respect to another inertial frame, then they are called accelerated frame. Accelerated frame. So in special theory of relativity, we are dealing with the inertial frame of reference. That is, the special in special theory of relativity means that we are confined, we confine ourselves to frame of reference. They are inertial. So inertial frames are frames of reference. They are moving with the uniform speed relative to each other. If they are moving with the uniform speed, then when I take an isolated particle, if a particle is isolated, then that particle will not experience any force in when we observe from inertial frame. So inertial frame is a frame of reference with respect to which an isolated object will be free from all the forces. Such a frame of reference is called inertial frame. In the case of accelerated frame of reference, if we are considering a particle, if we take an isolated particle, then with respect to accelerated frame, it will experience a force. In inertial frame, such isolated particles will not experience any forces. Now, consider a particle situated at this point. Then with respect to frame S, its coordinate is this direction. I am taking this direction as Z direction. The direction of motion of this frame of reference. The frame of reference is moving with a speed of V. V is the speed of frame of reference. Frame of reference, yes, with respect to, sorry, frame of reference, yes prime, with respect to, yes. We usually take V for representing the speed of frame and U for representing speed of particle. Speed of particle is represented by U, and I represent V for whenever V is appearing in an equation, you should remember that this V we are mentioning for speed of frame of reference and U for representing the speed of particle. So here, this frame is moving with a speed of V with respect to frame, yes. So its coordinate, we can write the coordinates as this coordinate, this is Z, so we can give X, Y, Z in anti-clockwise direction. The cross product Y cross I cross J should be equal to K. So the, if I represent this direction as X, then this one will be Y and this is Z direction. Here S prime frame, so I am taking X prime, Y prime, Z prime. Now mark the coordinates of this particle with respect to S and with respect to S prime. With respect to S prime, this Z coordinate. With respect to S, this one will be its Z coordinate. This much distance will be Z coordinate. With respect to S prime, this is origin of S prime. So with respect to S prime, this Z distance will be this one. So I am representing that as Z prime. This position vector of particle at position P with respect to the frame S, I can represent that by vector R. And this position vector is position vector of point P with respect to frame S prime. I am representing that that position vector as R prime. The particle is moving along the Z direction with a speed V. So its velocity of frame of reference, we can take it as vector V. Now the coordinate of this point, we can represent it as this distance. At t equal to 0, at time t equal to 0, let the two origins are coinciding each other. If they are coinciding each other, then after t time, at t equal to 0, S and S prime are coinciding. Coinciding each other. So after time t equal to t, the frame of reference, this frame is at rest and this one is moving with a speed of V, with a velocity V. So after t time, the displacement of frame of reference S prime will be velocity, the displacement of origin of the frame S prime will be velocity into time. So this distance will be Vt. So we can write vector R as vector R equal to vector R prime plus, this is vector R prime plus vector V into T. So I am taking this as equation number 1, vector R equal to vector R prime plus Vt, taking the differential dr by dt. Dr by dt equal to dr prime by dt plus v. What is dr by dt? Rate of change of position vector of the particle with respect to the frame S. So it should be the velocity of particle with respect to frame S. For representing the velocity of particle, I am taking the letter u. So this velocity is with respect to S. So I am taking that as u. U equal to dr by dt, which is the velocity of particle observed from the frame S, with respect to frame S. Now u prime is equal to dr prime by dt, which is the velocity of particle with respect to frame S prime. So for an observer in frame S prime, he will be feeling that the particle is moving with a velocity u prime, and for an observer in S, he will be feeling that the particle is moving with a velocity u. So the relation connecting the velocities, we can write the relation as u, dr by dt is u, u equal to u prime plus v, u prime plus v. So the velocity of particle observed by S will be u prime plus v, where v is the velocity of frame of reference and u prime is the velocity of particle observed by the frame S prime. Now, taking the differential of velocity, we can obtain the acceleration. Taking the differential of this one, du by dt equal to du prime by dt plus dv by dt. What is dv by dt? The frame is moving with the uniform speed. In special theory of relativity, we are dealing with the special frame of reference. We are dealing with the frame of reference. They are inertial. Inertial frames are having uniform velocity, so its acceleration should be zero. So for the frame of reference, inertial frame of reference, dv by dt equal to zero. If dv by dt equal to zero, then we are having du by dt. This is a equal to du prime by dt. I am taking a prime plus this one will be zero. So a equal to a prime, where a is the acceleration of particle with respect to frame S, and a prime is the acceleration of particle with respect to frame S prime. So the acceleration is same with respect to S and S prime. So this is the specialty of inertial frames. Since they are moving with the uniform relative velocities, the acceleration will be same when we observe from all the inertial frames. Since the acceleration is same, naturally the force will be the same. So whether you are observing from S or S prime, the force acting on the particle will be same, since A equal to A prime. So these are the properties of inertial frame of reference. In special theory of relativity, Einstein put forward two postulates. The first postulate is that the laws of physics are, the laws of physics are the same in all inertial frame of reference. So when you transform the coordinates from one frame of reference to another frame of reference, when you move from one frame to another frame, frame means inertial frame. Here we are dealing only with the inertial frame of references. So when we move from one frame of reference to another frame of reference, the laws of physics must be the same, or they should preserve the same form in all the frame of reference. You can transform the laws from the equations from one frame of reference to another frame of reference. They should be the form of equations or the laws should be same in all the frame of reference. Or in a systematic way, you can transform the equations in one frame of reference to another frame of reference. In other words, these equations should be covariant. Covariant means we can transform from one, using a systematic way, you can transform the equations in one frame of reference to another frame of reference. They should preserve the same form. So this is the first postulate of special theory of relativity. The laws of physics are the same in all inertial frame of reference. The second postulate is that the velocity of light is same. It is constant in all frames. So the velocity of light should be constant in all frames. Einstein strongly believed the Maxwell's equations, and Maxwell shown that the velocity of light is 1 by root of mu 0 epsilon 0. The velocity of light in free space velocity of light in free space is c equal to 1 by root of mu 0 epsilon 0. What is mu 0? Mu 0 is permeability of medium and epsilon 0 permeability of free space. Free space and epsilon 0 is permittivity of free space. That means the velocity of light in free space depends only on the electric and magnetic properties, which is the permeability and permittivity. They are constant in free space. Mu 0 and epsilon 0 are constant. That means the velocity of light is constant. So it should be independent of frame of reference. That means when you transform from, when you move from one coordinate system to another coordinate, there should not be any change in velocity of light. It should be constant in all the frame of reference. So we deal with the, now we discuss the coordinate transformation. We will transform from one coordinate system into another coordinate system. For that we will be, first we will take the Galilean transformation. In Galilean transformation, Galilean transformation, we are changing from one coordinate system Z, X, Y, Z, X, Y, Z. This prime is S prime, which is moving with a speed of V, and this prime S, which is at a rest. Consider a particle situated at this point. So its coordinate So this distance will be Z coordinate. This is the Z coordinate. Z coordinate with respect to the frame, yes. This one will be the Z coordinate with respect to frame, with respect to frame, S prime. So this I am taking it as Z prime. This distance traveled by the frame of reference will be V into T. X component, the X coordinate remains the same because there is no motion along the X direction, similarly along the Y direction. So the X and Y coordinates remains the same. So we can write the coordinate transformation. The new X coordinate, this is X prime, Y prime, Z prime. New X coordinate, X prime equal to X, Y prime equal to Y. Now Z prime, what is Z prime? Z prime, this total distance is Z and this distance traveled will be Vt. So Z prime will be equal to Z minus Vt. Time is, in Galilean transformation, time is taken as invariant. So time t prime equal to t. So these are the transformation equations for equations in Galilean transformation. And the inverse transformation, its inverse transformation can be written as x equal to x prime, y equal to y prime. Inverse transformation we can obtain by interchanging the sign of velocity. Z prime will become Z, Z will become Z prime, T will become T prime, but T prime equal to T, then V reverse its sign, minus V will become plus V. So it will be Z equal to Z prime plus VT, Z prime plus V, T prime equal to T. Here T equal to T prime. So these equations represent inverse transformation. Now taking the differential of this equation, Z prime equal to Z minus VT, will be having dZ prime by dt equal to dZ by dt minus V, or dZ prime by dt will be Z component of velocity. So we will be writing UZ prime equal to UZ minus V. Now UX prime will be equal to UX, UY prime will be equal to UY, u z prime. Since the frame of reference is moving along the z direction, the component of velocity along z direction will change, which is equal to u z prime equal to u z minus v. And we know that in Newtonian mechanics, if two particles are moving along the same direction, then its velocity velocity will be u z minus u v. So Newtonian mechanics is obeyed in Galilean transformation. Now we consider two objects. They are moving relative to each other. Consider two objects. Consider an object situated in consider this as a bus which is moving along this direction. Another bus. This is moving. This bus, I am taking this at rest. And this bus, which is moving with a speed of v along the positive z direction. Now from this bus, a man is throwing an object. A man is throwing an object along the direction of velocity. If this man is throwing an object along the direction of this velocity, then with respect to this observer, this let this velocity be with respect to the object at rest. If it is moving with a velocity u, I am taking this velocity as u, then the relative velocity observed for finding the relative velocity with respect to this prime. No, I am taking u as actually prime is given. This reference is s and this prime of reference is s prime. S prime is moving with a velocity v. So with respect to s prime, its velocity is u prime. U prime is the velocity of particle with respect to s prime. The velocity of particle observed by prime s, that we will take it as u. U is the velocity of particle observed by s. A person sitting in bus A, he will observe with a velocity u, and a person sitting on the bus B, he will observe the particle with a velocity u prime, and the transformation equation from u to u prime is u prime equal to, we have written u prime equal to u minus v, or u equal to u prime plus v. So this fellow is throwing with a velocity u prime, and this frame of reference is already moving with a velocity v. Then this object, the man sitting on this bus, he will experience, he will feel that the object is having a velocity u prime plus v. Instead of that, if I take, instead of throwing a ball, if he is having a light source and he is, the source is emitting light, then based on Galilean transformation, so this bus, the man standing on the bus B, he is lighting a torus, so he is emitting a light. The light is moving with a speed c with respect to this man, and this prime is moving with a velocity v. Then with respect to the observer A, according to Galilean transformation, with respect to the observer A, he will feel a velocity u equal to u prime plus v. Here u prime is equal to c. Then he will feel that the light will be moving with a velocity c plus v. But according to the postulate of second postulate of special theory of relativity, we know that the velocity of light is constant. It should not change when we move from one frame to another frame. That means this Galilean transformation is cannot be used in the case of a special theory of relativity. In special theory of relativity, we cannot change the velocity of light. The velocity of light remains constant when we move from one frame of reference to another frame of reference. But in Galilean transformation, the velocity is found to be c plus v when we observe from the frame A, c is the velocity of light observed from the man sitting on the bus B, but the man sitting on the bus A, he will feel that it is emitted with a velocity c plus b. So this will violate the Maxwell's equations. So Einstein strongly believed the Maxwell's equation. So we cannot use the Galilean transformation in special theory of relativity. And we also assumed that in earlier times we assumed that there is a medium called ether, and all the planets, earth, sun, all these objects are floating on the medium ether, and the motion ether is at absolute rest, and we can specify the motion with respect to that ether medium. Based on that, Michelson Morley did the experiment, and they found that the velocity in different direction should change based on Galilean transformation. The velocity should change when the medium is moving, or when the observer is moving, or when the source is moving. Based on this equation, if the source is moving, or if the observer is moving, or the medium is moving, then the velocity of light should change. So based on that, they send a light in two perpendicular directions, and they observed that there is no change in velocity of light, and the experiment was having a negative result, so the presence of ether was neglected. So there is no absolute motion, there is no medium at all, and there is no absolute motion. The absolute state of system is taken as uniform motion rather than state of rest, and we need a new transformation equation which is consistent with the special theory of relativity. For that, we will be doing Lorentz transformation that we will study in next class. Thank you.